Today, I want us to look at this scripture. This particular scripture. And as a scripture that will give you some kind of boldness in Christ Jesus. When you read Luke chapter 9, verse number 1, it says, then he called his 12 disciples together and gave them power and authority over all demons and to cure diseases. Jesus Christ gave the disciples power and authority. He gave them power and authority. He did not only give them power, but he added authority to it. Over what? Over all devils. Not some of them. Not the ones that are big, the ones that are small. The Bible says Jesus Christ gave us, we that are disciples, power and authority over all devils and to cure diseases. So there is no disease, there is no sickness that we cannot heal. It didn't say Jesus cannot heal. Say there is no sickness or there is no disease that we cannot heal. Jesus received power from God and gave that power to us. We Christians, not only wisdom, we gave it to all Christians. See, I am part of them. You are part. The body of Christ have that power. We have that power. We don't have it as in just in theory, but in practical. It says, and he called his 12 disciples together and gave them power and authority over all devils and to cure diseases. He gave them power. You that you are hearing me, you are watching me right now, you have power over all sickness, over all diseases. Many Christians, I don't know how you were trained, how you were taught, how you got your beginning in Christianity. But you see, Jesus Christ gave the disciples power and authority over all devils, not some. All devils, not some. All devils, the one tormenting you right now. Jesus Christ has given you power over that demon. You have that power. You have that authority. You have that dominion over all devils. And authority over all devils. You decide what happened. Authority means that you have power. You have the requisite power over to decide what happened. You decide in your area what happened. You decide in your location what happened. In your department, in your workplace, what happened. You decide, you the Christian, you decide what happened. How you want things to go, that is how it goes. The one you want it to go this way, they'll go this way. You authority means that you decide what happened. You don't wait. No time to wait. You exercise your authority now. Whatever is worrying you, you command that demon, leave now. I refuse to allow your work or your operations around me. Leave now and use the name of Jesus Christ. Who gave us the power? It's Jesus Christ who gave us that power. Since it is Jesus Christ who gave us that power, it's a delegated power. It means he had that power, gave it to us, just like the president giving the senator or the regional minister or the governor power, or like the president asking the prime minister to do something. The prime minister, by his own discretion, gave power or exercise that power. It means that he now received power, but he exercised the power the way he wanted to go. We have that power as Christians. We have it now. So you exercise the power you have. Don't wait for anyone. Don't wait. Don't be waiting for Jesus Christ. Even don't wait for Jesus Christ to do anything for you, because he has already given you the power. So he's waiting for you to exercise your power. Jesus Christ is waiting for you to exercise the power he has given you. If you can hear me, you can watch this clip now. You have power. This is the reason why I said you have power. You must agree with the Bible. If you agree with the Bible, it will work perfectly for you. The Bible says that then he called his 12 disciples together and gave them power and authority over all devils and to cure diseases. This is a good news. This news is a good one, that I now have power. I decide what happened at my workplace. I decide the number of people that come to purchase my goods. I decide, because I don't only have power, I have authority. I have authority. We Christians are not people who are supposed to be begging. We are supposed to be exercising the power we have. The message is coming to a close today, and we'll continue another time. God bless you. Remember to exercise your power. Remember to speak with authority. Remember to use the name of Jesus Christ to take dominion in wherever you are, in whatever area you are, in any town that you are. Things must go the way you want it to go. Sure, they must all go the way you want it to go. So, and that is how it's going to be, because that is how Jesus Christ wanted to go. God bless you for hearing this message today. And we'll meet again next time. Bye-bye.